What's up? My name is Kevin.
My name Ryan.
Thank you for tuning in to this week's installment of Chopsticks Forks. Pretty much today we are in the Bronx.
The BX.
For the first time we have infiltrated the Bronx. We're here on East Tremont Avenue. And today we're going to take a walk on the Latino side.
That's right.
Ooh. On the Hispanic side.
That's right.
On the Spanish side. And we are going to enjoy some Cuban cuisine.
That's right.
So please, stay tuned. I promise you, you're going to love it.
Let's go.
Guys, so we are here inside Havana Cafe, and of course we started with the appetizers.
That's right.
As you can see, I got this shrimp, beautiful concoction right here.
Beautiful.
The garlic bread next to it. You can just look at that and tell. This is the real deal, and I'm going to give this a try right now.
And just in case, we got the hot sauce on there.
Starters, this shrimp is about as close to perfect as you can make it. It has the sauce on it, and it has the garlic bread on the side. Let's just put it like this. This is probably the best appetizer I've gotten in a very long time. I love it. Ryan, please.
So, back to me. Over here, what we have is pita bread and hummus. So, they call it the hummus Latino. Okay? All my Spanish people are. So, hopefully I'll be soon enough. So, I'm gonna dip this in here. Oh yeah. This is perfectly seasoned. The pita bread is on point. Everything is spectacular.
Alright guys, so right here actually I have two dishes. One is actually yuca fries and this is bahia vejiana. For all the Spanish speaking people, please don't judge me. My Spanish is not great. But before I take my first bite, I just want to clarify a simple thing. In episode 2, when I said that I transitioned myself to a vegan diet, honestly, I really thought about it. I'm not 100% vegan. I'm just giving you healthier options on top of vegetarian dishes. For the dessert aspect, I'm just gonna eat whatever I want. No disrespect to all the vegans out there. I love y'all, but that's just how it's gonna go down. But I'm about to have my first bite of this, which consists of a lot of good veggies on top of saffron rice. So, this is like going to the actual traditional Spanish restaurant. The season, the flavors, everything is just meshing well together, even though I say that 24/7. But even without any consistency of meat, it feels like I'm just eating really, really good food. And the word of my day to describe this, it's spectacular. And right here, I'm gonna try out the yuca fries. I wanted it to be unique, a little bit different. Usually I get sweet potato fries or regular fries, but yuca fries, I had to try it out myself. So. It's crunchy on the outside, it's very soft in the inside, which it really, really makes the yuca very, very flavorful. On top of the seasoning on top, spectacular. So that's all I have to say about that.
Alright guys, so now everybody knows me as King Chicken, because pretty much everything I do, I specialize in a different taste in chicken.
That's true.
But today, I got a salmon burger. That's right, a salmon burger. It has chipotle, it has peppers, it has avocado. And we're gonna give this salmon burger a try. One second, let me shmoney real quick. Alright. This is probably, no joking, top 5 burger I've ever had. Like ever. Like in my whole lifespan, top 5 burger. I've never had salmon prepared like this. It's a salmon patty, but it's actually salmon. Not like that. Mixed artificial thrown in stuff. No. This is actual salmon in patty form with the avocado and the chipotle and the peppers. And if I don't recommend anything, you need to try this. Guaranteed. If you excuse me, I'm gonna polish this off. I'm gonna catch y'all on the flip side. Listen, guys, I'm gonna be straight with you. It's one of the top 5 places we've ever been.
That's very, very true.
It's a 5 out of 5 rating across the board. Uh-huh. You saw my salmon burger. I don't need to say anything else but that. If you excuse me. With that said, guys, I'm giving Havana Cafe 5 out of 5 forks, no question.
And I personally give it a 10 out of 10 chopsticks, even though we don't do 10 out of 10, but that place is really off the hook, especially as our first time in the BX. You guys made us proud. You guys represented. So all across the board, everything.
Shout out to all my people, all my friends, all the fans, all the viewers in the Bronx. You guys represented today.
That's right.
That said, thanks so much for tuning in. Be sure to like, subscribe, comment below, check out our website, chopsticksandforksnyc.com.
And stay tuned for each week for the word of the day with me.